You received a letter this week from a Mr. Pat Sherman, CPA. Plus, he's had some rhetoric in the newspaper that I feel it's kind of appropriate for us to respond to right now, so that he understands exactly what our position is.
Is council okay with that? Council okay with that?
Yes.
Council okay, go ahead.
The first thing that I would say, and Mr. Sherman has said this now in two different letters to me, there is no case, there is no statute which stands for the proposition that his reorganization committee has exclusive jurisdiction over this area. It just doesn't exist. I'm well aware of the cases he cites in his letter. I was lead counsel on the Fishers annexation. I doubt very seriously if anybody knows more about that annexation than I do. What Mr. Sherman is going to have to do is ask some Indiana court, probably it would be the Indiana Supreme Court, to make new law in order to support the position that he's taking in that letter. And I would tell you that the only time anything even remotely close to this has occurred was in the Zionsville Eagle Township reorganization when Whitestown was engaged in annexations. And the position that those communities adopted was directly contrary to the position Mr. Sherman advocates in his letter. In fact, his own law firm was representing Whitestown in connection with those efforts. And the position that those communities followed was, until the reorganization committee had developed its plan and submitted it to the two units of government that were going to vote on that reorganization, they did not have a stake in the ground. And so any annexations that Whitestown had commenced up until the time that occurred were allowed to proceed. So he is asking for new law. And he can claim, oh, it's void, or he can claim, he can cite all the cases he wants that don't stand for that proposition. There is no case that stands for that proposition. It just isn't out there. This is new ground, and he's asking for new law. The second, and I think more fundamental problem with what I hear from Mr. Sherman is the perception that somehow this annexation is causing a problem with the reorganization. There is a simple solution to the problem that he perceives. I suspect it's a solution that escapes him because he's not elected by anyone, and he answers to Greenwood. I would doubt very seriously if any subject that Mr. Sherman's group has studied, could he find 90% of any population segment to agree with. That's a monumental number. I doubt very seriously, so we could probably go around the room and I'll bet we couldn't get 90% of us to agree what time it is. I'm 7:12, I'm 7:10, so I'm already off. Well, that's what we've got. 90% of the people in this area have told him unequivocally, leave us alone.
Yes, sir.
The simple solution, and his committee has this totally within its power, the simple solution to the problem that he has created in his mind, when that committee sits down to prepare the draft of the reorganization plan that it's going to submit to White River Township and to the city of Greenwood, leave these people out. They have that power to do that. It solves all the problems. And ironically, when this precise issue was going on in Zionsville, in Eagle Township, and Whitestown, that's exactly what they did. I would recommend Mr. Sherman consult with his own lawyers and find out that's what worked up there, that's what will work down here. So, problem solved. Mr. Sherman, leave these people out. And that would be my response to Mr. Sherman. I don't intend to reduce this to writing. I don't think he deserves a response. He doesn't live in this area. He isn't a property owner in this area. He is not a constituent of yours. He's heard my response.
Thank you for that clarification. I'm sure that council echoes that, and I'm sure the town does too.
Now, just to respond one more time to Mr. Sherman, I will tell you, I wouldn't pick a fight with these people, because if you pick a fight with them, that organization would kill any chance of the reorganization passing. these people are to be commended. They are motivated, they are organized, and for them to go out and get signatures from 90% of the property owners in an annexation this big is shocking. Would have never thought it was possible.